I'm not them.
Have you ever played a game that had the potential to be great if it weren't for a single element dragging the entire experience down to an almost unplayable level? Even within the realm of mobile gaming, I can recall a few personal examples. The excessively randomized upgrades in War of the Visions, the daunting grind for character progression in Love Live All-Stars, and the overwhelming number of characters to manage in Ensemble Stars, just to name a few. However, in all of those games, I could at least manage to play them for a week before frustration set in. Unfortunately, the same cannot be said for Reverse 1999.
50 minutes left. Come on, let's move.
Please use this. It will send us directly to the other side.
Normally, this would be the part of the review where I'd go over the back of the box story summary, but I really can't here because this particular stumble truly happens right out of the gate. Reverse 1999 begins with a long, long series of cutscenes, all of which immediately communicate the single biggest problem weighing this game down. The localization is atrociously bad. Almost every dialogue box contains unnatural, potentially machine-translated sentences that quickly made it difficult for me to keep track of what was supposed to be happening. This is made even more baffling by the full dub that this publisher paid for because these actors are clearly struggling against their material, being forced to read sentences that are either incomplete or do not resemble human speech. They're doing their best to communicate their characters' personalities, but it can just never be enough when absolutely no work was done to make them sound like real people in English. The story, I think, follows a time-traveling timekeeper who is able to predict upcoming storms, which are supernatural events that displace those caught in them in time. We start by meeting Regulus, a young pirate captain in the 60s, and then get taken back to the 20s shortly afterward. The cutscenes, typical for a mobile game, are rendered in shiny live 2D graphics with some 3D particle effects over top. The presentation is actually solid all around, with an art style that reminds me a little of Twisted Wonderland, eye-popping battle effects, and a gorgeous soundtrack. It all comes together into a unique, evocative aesthetic that is definitely being used to Reverse 1999's advantage in the game's aggressive marketing campaign, and this accompanies a battle system that, while simple, is refreshingly different from the dozens of simplistic RPGs on the platform where characters just have two abilities on cooldowns. In battle, you draw a hand of cards determined by your chosen party and a set pool of action points. You can spend a point in two different ways, by casting one of the card spells in order to attack, defend, buff your party, or debuff your enemies, or you can reposition one of the cards in your hand. If like cards are next to each other, they fuse into a stronger spell that costs the same single action point to cast, and this creates a satisfying scenario of moving one card in your hand to trigger a chain reaction of fusions, forecasting either a fully charged attack or your character's flashy ultimate move. To be blunt, the current state of the game provides enjoyable combat, but it's the only aspect that's enjoyable. The crippling issue is the poorly executed script, which drags down Reverse 1999 as a whole. As a seasoned mobile gamer, this is the first game I've reviewed that I actively don't want to play because I see it as a waste of potential. In its current state, unless a player solely focuses on the aesthetic appeal of gacha characters and disregards the need for them to have personalities or engage in a compelling storyline, it's challenging to envision anyone enjoying this game long enough to keep it alive. There might be a promising time travel story here with plenty of potential ideas, but it's hard to follow when almost every voiced line of dialogue is distractingly subpar. Noisy Pixel is giving Reverse 1999 a 4 out of 10. Thanks for watching, and thanks to our Patreon subscribers for helping to keep our independent operation going. Noisy Pixel is run by a group of gamers working hard to give you the latest news, previews, reviews, and more. Go to patreon.com/noisypixel for details on how you can help, and like, comment, and subscribe to keep up with our future content. Noisy Pixel.